Last time on Out Chasing Stars, we arrived into the Maldives and were welcomed like family at the island of Utheemu. We greatly enjoyed our time there, exploring the island and its beautiful waters before checking out another nearby anchorage at Utheemu. After a few days there, we upped anchor alongside Slow Flight and left this little corner of paradise. We had 2 weeks to island hop down to Male, the capital of the Maldives, to pick up our friends. Good morning there, babe.
Good morning.
How's it going so far today?
It's hot.
It is hot.
There is not a lot of wind.
No wind.
But it's still beautiful and we're still in the Maldives, so...
Life could be a lot worse, that's for sure.
It could be a lot worse, yeah. We saw dolphins this morning, too.
Always a great start to the day, yeah.
Yeah.
And so where are we headed? Gonna make you say the name of the island.
Utheemu.
I think we got it right. U Island is what I've been calling it.
U Island, yes. And we do... The only thing we know is that there's a wooden palace that's supposed to be hundreds of years old here.
I did a little bit of research this morning, and I think apparently the Utheemu was actually... the center of a dynasty here in the Maldives, and one of the sultans helped kick out the Portuguese, and so this was his seat of power, apparently.
Okay.
So
good history lesson.
That's what we know. We'll see if we can manage to anchor there, because there's no real easy anchor spot. It's just kind of like there's a reef around the island and then deep, deep shelf. So we'll see if we can find a spot, maybe to anchor, get ashore. We've heard that the palace is now a museum, so hopefully we can get ashore, learn a little bit more, and have a cultural experience in the Maldives, which sound like they might be a little hard to come by.
Yes. Beautiful anchorages seem to be par for the course, but the culture and history, we may not have that so much.
Not quite as much as, say, Indonesia or Malaysia or...
Or pretty much anywhere else we've been.
Anywhere else we've been,
yeah. Okay.
Like many of the islands in the Maldives that are inhabited, Utheemu has a man-made harbor to provide shelter for the local boats and fishermen. Plus, it's a handy place to park a dinghy for visiting boats. Not many cruisers come here, so it's no surprise that we made a new friend, Bale, who became our guide for the island. But first, we had to lounge in the shade, local style.
Go ahead.
He's exercising over there.
Right?
It's pretty comfortable.
It's very comfortable. These are Maldivian hammock chairs. I don't know, they didn't say they had a name for them.
It looks like what we need on Starry Horizons, though.
Right?
Put this up front, nice and relaxed.
Simple enough, you just get some netting and...
That's true, we have seen swing hammock chairs, which is really cool.
That sounds pretty nice. Lounging done, we set off to walk through the town and find the Utheemu Palace. Typical to the Maldivian villages we'd seen, this one had schools, football fields, a mosque, and was largely powered by solar panels. Unfortunately, we didn't realize it was a public holiday. However, our new friend Bale came to our rescue and made a call to get the grounds unlocked. While we waited, he showed us the kanai tree, a tree that's over 500 years old and supposedly grew from a prop for a loom. In the 1500s, woven Maldivian fabrics was a large export to the rest of the world.
Ready?
Yeah.
See, we know people. The wood is really beautiful. Very dark in there.
Yeah. What did you find there, my dear?
He said there's a little hole that, like... I guess you can see out instead of see in, but...
A 500-year-old security system, huh?
Yeah. But it's very nice in here. The wood carving, the wood doors are really cool looking. Oh, there's a bigger hole. Very dark.
This palace was once home to Muhammad Thakaru Fanu. During the time of Portuguese rule, locals were being forced to convert from Islam to Christianity, or face death. Muhammad and his brothers gathered a small navy and together defended their islands. He then became the first Sultan of the Maldives.
This one?
Did you find another interesting door?
Yeah, so this door is stuck and it's like it was locked, but they don't understand the mechanism that was used to lock it. They've tried really hard to open this door without destroying it, and nothing's working. So,
kind of wild.
Yeah, and like you can see holes in it and pitting from when they were working on it. But it's a pretty neat door.
So the Uber security system, build a lock, no one will remember how to open.
Exactly. It's like locking the door and throwing away the key.
We are drinking this one.
So you drink this water?
Yeah, you can drink, no problem.
Yeah, yeah.
Ooh.
How's it taste, babe?
Oops, sorry.
Very good.
Oh, yeah. That is fantastic.
Oh, God.
Honey, are you okay?
I thought I was too short.
As it turns out, today is a public holiday because it's the election counting day here in the Maldives, and that's why the palace was closed, even though we managed to find our way in. And so the island is all decked out in colors for the different parties. Apparently they just announced that one candidate won, rather than like CNN or something like that announcing results. It's done over the public PA in the island. Kind of a cool way. After we just finished up lunch, we were walking back towards the harbor to head back to the boats, and Bale was like, you guys want to see the boat building? We were like, yes! It turns out this is a massive, massive boat behind us, and so I suppose if we want to have our next boat built, just come back to the Maldives. Back on the move again. That was always just gonna be a little bit of a day stop because the anchoring there was not great. Kind of just right up to the edge of the reef, back up a little bit, try to find the ledge, and then drop. So not a great overnight spot. So we are headed off to our island, subtitled below with the name. And this was a really awesome little spot and one we weren't really anticipating going to. Trevor and Kimmy were the ones who knew about this place. And you know, even with the fact that it was a public holiday, it was just so nice. We've seen this so many places where people just decide to help us out, open us up, or open up the place we wanted to see, even though it was closed. Just take their time to show us around the island, tell us about things. It just makes it really special when we get a chance to meet people like that. Going in the water?
I'm going in. It's hot, guys.
Do it.
Oh, it feels so good.
Nice and chilly?
It feels colder here than in the other places.
We are anchored at like 90 something feet, so Makes sense.
Yeah. Shorts are riding up.
Ooh la.
Yeah.
Well, don't worry, you're disappearing into the dinghy, so.
I'm floating away.
No, bye. Come back.
Or is Starry Horizons floating away?
Wow, chicken or the egg. This spot was a deep anchorage, out of sight from any villages. We dropped anchor in 90 feet, barely enough for a 3-to-1 scope. With no wind, we were able to enjoy this beautiful anchorage for 3 days, swimming, snorkeling, and even having a delicious treat. that, Amy. Trevor, what'd you get, man? Oh my God, that is amazing. And let's see that shot. It's like right in between the eyes. Nice.
We are on the move today. We had an amazing three nights at our very remote, beautiful anchorage. Did some snorkeling. Trevor caught that bomb lobster, so that was freaking cool. We are headed into a town. Kalafushi, I think is the name.
I think that's pretty close.
Something like that. Basically, we're gonna pull into the harbor, the southern harbor, dock to the wharf, get some diesel. We're gonna stay the night there and pay the harbor charges. But we're gonna use it as an opportunity to have some dinner out, do some shopping. We have to rent an ATM to pay cash for the diesel. But we are almost on E, so it's
getting
time.
A little low, and we want to be able to use that air conditioning because God, is it hot.
David had a hard time sleeping last night.
First time ever I came up and slept outside.
Yeah.
Ever. Four and a half years.
So it's been pretty calm, pretty hot. But you know, we're enjoying the water clarity and the beauty of the islands and atolls, so you know, it has its pros and cons.
Just like every place, yeah?
Just like every place. Kimmy and Trevor and I are on a little adventure. Say hi, guys!
Hi, guys!
Yay! All right, so Starry Horizons is docked here at Kalafushi, I think. And we're waiting on the fuel guy, but Kimmy and Trevor and I are headed into town to look for an ATM and more provisioning.
Got it? You got it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You're back and looking a little sweaty there, babe.
Yeah, it's pretty hot out there.
We keep saying this, but that's because it's so hot.
And we knew this going in. It's all right, it is what it is. But we got our errands done, but we didn't really get as much done as I hoped. I did get to an ATM because the ATM kiosks are always open. But most of the shops are closed for prayer because this is a Muslim country. So I wasn't able to do our SIM card thing, but I did get some lovely produce here. Look at these gorgeous, giant imported heads of broccoli.
You mean mini trees?
Yeah, it is definitely a mini tree here. So we're well stocked with vegetables, with eggs, and then got some interesting stuff. Here in the Maldives, it's Muslim. But I suspect that they get a lot of their meats from India because that's the closest place. So the meats are all halal. And then it is, instead of beef, this is halal buffalo.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah, so it was basically chicken buffalo and duck, but the ducks were whole, so I didn't want to buy a whole duck. So I got us some buffalo to try and a little bit of chicken. And oh, and then the big treat. We have plenty of barbecue sauce. I wasn't going to run out, y'all. Don't worry. But if you see it, you should buy it.
Yeah.
So this amazing looking barbecue sauce, and I bought the store out.
Well, I always appreciate that.
Yeah, so we're not going to run out of barbecue sauce anytime soon.
Excellent. And so now we're just waiting for the fuel truck to arrive.
Waiting for the fuel truck to arrive, and then this evening we will go have dinner ashore with Kimmy and Trevor, and also top up our SIM cards.
It can be very important to do that.
And check out, there's another grocery store that's not open right now, so we'll go check that out too.
Gonna be a busy day.
Always is on these administrative days.
We are still here at the wharf. We've been here for about 7 hours now, and there's no sign of fuel still. Apparently, we have been told there is a brand new form, only been out for like a day, that no one knows how to fill out. So customs has told us that our agent's supposed to fill it out. Our agent says no. The fuel company's supposed to fill it out. Fuel company's like, no, 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 that's a customs form. But apparently, it's been kicked up to the headquarters for the fuel company. We're still not entirely sure what's going on. All I know is that we don't have diesel yet, and the sun's going down, so odds are not looking very good today. And this is not a very good statement for a bureaucracy in the Maldives. A week to take it took to get our cruising permit, and then new forms just at random that no one knows how to use. So that's kind of frustrating, but I guess we are on the literal definition of island time. Update time. 24 hours after we've arrived, still here at the wharf, and no word quite yet on when the fuel might be coming. Apparently the holdup is a new export form that apparently requires a broker of some sort, and the fuel company here is not technically a broker, so they have to find a broker who can actually sell us the fuel. Like, the Maldives are gorgeous, absolutely beautiful, beaches lovely, water clear, coral's dead, that kind of sucks. But the administrative issues are not impressive so far. Getting a little disappointed in that.
What just happened?
It has taken us 27 and a half hours to get our fuel truck here.
And it's finally on the dock.
It's finally on the dock. I'm gonna be real pissed if that's not our truck. But yeah, we're the only two boats here. So better be our fuel.
Yeah. Well, let's get some fuel and get that aircon on again.
It's fuel time.
I'm sure you could hear in our voices. We were quite excited to leave bureaucracy behind and go in search of our own private five-star resort. Hey, y'all. Thank you for checking out our second Maldives video. Just wanted to know that I know the video is a little slow in coming out right now, but we are working on them hard, like that's the Atlantic Ocean behind me, so we are working on them while we're on passage, trying to get them out. Now, I do want to clarify one thing from this video. We did not mean for it to sound as if there was no culture in the Maldives, because there most certainly is. The people were incredibly friendly, we enjoyed learning about their history and everything like that, but there is not a lot of sites of cultural significance, especially when you compare it to like Sri Lanka or Thailand or some of those places that we've been to. So just want to clarify, very important to note, but make sure you stick around, check out our next video, because we are going to an abandoned five-star resort. It's pretty freaking awesome, so make sure you stick around, check that out. We'll see y'all later.